திருமணன் சார்
சொல்லுங்க.
தெரியுது சார், சார் சார்
வந்துட்டாங்க. குட் ஈவினிங் அருண் சார்.
வெரி குட் ஈவினிங் சார், எப்படி இருக்கீங்க? I think ready with everything, right?
Yeah, 5 minutes.
Okay, then I think I'll laptop connect panikiren.
Ah, sure sir.
Sir, ellarume admit kekranga, na admit pannuma illa neenga kekringa sir?
Na panikiren.
Okay sir, sir na edhavadhu panna vendi irukna solirenga na.
Illa neenga neenga screen share pannala, neenga ungalada pesikalam.
Avladha.
Na matha work ellame na paathiren. Onnum prachana illa.
Okay sir, okay sir. ஹோஸ்ட் டிசேபிள்ட் தான் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங் போட்டுருக்கு சார்.
இல்லையா உங்களுக்கு
ஹோஸ்ட் டிசேபிள்ட் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங்?
ஒரு நிமிஷம்,
உங்களுக்கு ஹோஸ்ட் டிசேபிள்ட் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங் வருது பாருங்க.
ஒரு நிமிஷம் இப்போ
கொடுங்க. ஓகே சார், ஓகே சார். ஒரு நிமிஷம் பண்றேன். சார் எப்பயும் அப்படிதான் வருது, ஹோஸ்ட் டிசேபிள்ட் பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங். ஹோஸ்ட் டிசேபிள்ட் பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங் தான் வருது.
ஒரு நிமிஷம், ஒரு நிமிஷம், நீங்க எதுல இருக்கீங்க? அருண் கேஎஸ் னு இருக்கு, அதுவா?
ஆமா, அது அதுதான், அதுதான்.
அது ஓகே ஓகே ஓகே. ஒரு நிமிஷம், ஏன்னா நீங்க ரெண்டு இதுல இருந்து வந்திருக்கீங்கல்ல, உங்களுக்கு ஆப்ஷன் மாறி இருக்கு.
சரி சரி. Okay, got it, sir. ஓகே, ஸோ 4:30க்கு இன்னும் 1 மினிட் இருக்கு, ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாமா? 4:30 ஆயிடுச்சு.
ஸோ நீங்க
எப்பன்னு சொல்லுங்க, ரெடியா சொல்லுங்க, வி வில் ஸ்டார்ட்.
ஓகே சார், 2 மினிட்ஸ்.
ஓகே, நோ ப்ராப்ளம், நோ ப்ராப்ளம்,
திஸ் வில் ஸ்டார்ட். சுரேஷ் சார், ஷல் வி ஸ்டார்ட் நவ?
ஐயோ எஸ் சார், எஸ் சார்.
ஓகே முனிஸ், ஓகே
சார். இப்ப வந்து இந்த பிபிடி நான் நெக்ஸ்ட் பிபிடி போறேன், ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா நான் இதுல இருக்கு. நான் அதுல
எனக்கு இன்னும் எனக்கு இன்னும் உங்க ஸ்கிரீன் எனக்கு ஷோ ஆகல.
அப்படியா?
ஆமா,
இப்ப தெரியுதுங்களா?
ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங் இருக்குது, சர்ஃப் ஆயிட்டு இருக்கு, இன்னும் வரல.
இப்ப வருதுங்களா?
இல்லையே,
பாருங்க. எனக்குமே இங்க அருண்குமார் ஸ்டார்டிங் ஸ்கிரீன் ஷேரிங் தான் வந்திருக்கு, எனக்கு இங்க விசிபிள் ஆகுது.
அதுதான், நீங்க ஸ்டாப் ஷேரிங் கொடுத்து திரும்பி பண்ணுங்க. லேப்டாப்ல இருந்து தானே பண்றீங்க?
ஆமா ஆமா,
திரும்பி பண்ணுங்க.
ஓகே, ஓகேவா சார்? தெரியுதுங்களா?
வரல சார்.
நான் கொடுத்துட்டேன், ஸ்டாப் ஷேரிங் கொடுத்துட்டு ஸ்டார்ட் ஷேரிங் கொடுத்துட்டேன், எனக்கு இங்க வந்துருச்சு.
எனக்கு இங்க ஸ்கிரீன் வரல, அதான் கேக்குறேன்.
எனக்கும் என்னோட நான் என்ன அல்டர்னேட்டிவ் இதுல பாக்குறேன்ல, அதுலயுமே அருண்குமார் ஸ்டார்டட் ஷேரிங் தி ஸ்கிரீன் தான் வருது.
அதான் எனக்கு இருக்கு, நெட் ஸ்லோவா இருக்கோ?
இல்ல சார், நல்லா இருக்கு, ஃபுல் ஸ்ட்ரென்த்ல தான் இருக்கு. எனக்கு இங்க நான் டிஸ்கனெக்ட் பண்ணிட்டு மறுபடியும்
பண்ணுங்க.
Join with computer audio. Yeah. Is it visible now, sir? Can you see me?
Sir?
Can you see me, sir? Hello, sir.
You can share your screen.
Okay.
Yes, it's shown.
Is it okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
Perfect. Okay, that's great. ஏன்னா எனக்கு இப்பதான் போன்ல தெரியுது கிளியரா.
ஓகே, ஃபைன் ஃபைன்.
சோ வித் யுவர் பெர்மிஷன், இஃப் யூ சே எஸ் வி வில்.
ஹலோ, அருண் சார், டெல் மீ.
எஸ் சார், ஷல் வி? ஷல் வி? இஃப் யூ சே எஸ் வி வில் ஸ்டார்ட்.
ஓகே ஓகே சார், ஓகே ஃபைன். நவ ஐ இன்வைட்.
ஒரு நிமிஷம், எனக்கு இங்க F5 ஃபுல் ஸ்கிரீனா ப்ளீஸ். எஸ் சார்.
Good evening everyone. Now I invite Mr. T.A. Suresh, HOD English Department, to give a welcome address. Suresh sir. Hello.
Hello.
Good evening.
Sir, England, sir.
Yes.
Okay sir. Shall we start now sir?
Yes. Start sir. Continue please.
Good afternoon to one and all. On behalf of Vannai College of Arts and Science, I take privilege to welcome our respected principal, vice principal, and the honorable chief guest, Dr. Arun Kumar sir, managing director, NCF Academy, and all the participants. I wholeheartedly welcome to you on webinar, The Positive Attitude and Emotional Intelligence. Once again, I welcome யூ ஆல் தேங்க்யூ சார்
தேங்க்யூ சார் தேங்க்யூ நவ் ஐ ஹேண்ட் ஓவர் த செஷன் டு அவர் கெஸ்ட் டாக்டர் அருண்குமார் சார் வெல்கம் யூ சார்
ஓகே தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் Thank you so much, sir, for this warm welcome. Very good evening to everybody. I believe that everybody can listen to my voice and the screen. If at all you have an issue, please raise your hand so that we will not have any kind of interruption or anything. Thank you for that. Okay, the management, Anne College management, please, I really heartfelt thanks for this wonderful opportunity to the principals and the all delegates over here and the HOD of English department. Thank you so much for this opportunity. Before I start with my session, let me have a small introduction about me. As sir told about me is like my full name is Arun Kumar Selvam, with 9 years experience of the same training in development industry, with various expertise in topic on soft skill, communication, and verbal English. These are all my specialized sector or the section of this training industry. So I've been to this so many states, like almost I've covered 25 states, participated many colleges and trained more than 6,000 students nationally. It is my first experience in Tamil Nadu, that too in Kumbakonam, and they have invited me for this wonderful opportunity and thank you for that. Yes. It is a wonderful topic that they have given me to proceed, is emotional intelligence. It is not something that I'm going to teach you. No, not at all. It is something which we have already and we are going to realize that. So, emotional intelligence and positive attitude. Why this required? Why we need to know about this? So, first, let us understand, sir, I have some issue in my screen, my laptop. It is getting reconnected. I'm sorry for the interruption. Suresh, sir?
Okay, sir.
It is getting reconnected in my laptop. I'm not able to connect it so that I think you all can hear my voice.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I don't think so that if any technical issues comes, that will take away our time. So I don't mind. So let me proceed with the points. Okay, thank you, Rathore sir. Yes, let us start with the word called emotions. Yes, everybody use this word. You are emotional, you are sensitive, you are sensible, you are highly irritating. So what do you mean by emotion? Everybody knows it. Let me give you a few calls. Since I am being a psychologist, I would like to give a brief idea or brief information about this. Emotion means simple, mood and the feelings. What do we feel connected to our mood? Excuse me, it's asking me to rejoin so that I can show you the PPT. So give me a few seconds so that I'll rejoin in the meeting. Okay, meanwhile it is connected, let me continue with my part. As I told you, emotions deals with feelings and mood. What is that difference? Feelings, as per the study, and there are so many psychologists, they have mentioned Mr. Lecture is a person who categorized emotions as a 6-part. Feeling joy, feeling happy, feeling sad, and anger, disgust, sadness, surprise. These are all the emotions which all the human beings expose to the other human being. And few other people also have categorized into pairs of things like sad and happy, anger and disgust, guilt and pain. Like this, they have categorized. So all these kinds of human behavior and human emotions involved in our day-to-day activity that we meet with people, where we meet with other people, how we treat with others, that etc. These are all the emotions we expose to the public and the relationship which we deal with. So that's all about emotions. Intelligence, yes. Let me take this second word called intelligence. Yes. As we all are highly educated and we all know the meaning of intelligence, still I would like to describe or explain in a few words about intelligence. Nothing but reasoning ability, how to act according to the situation. That's all. I repeat once again, reasoning ability to act and react to a certain situation. Okay, that's all about emotion and intelligence. That's it. Then why we need to talk about this much? Yes, most of them do not know how to handle these parameters, as I have listed few feelings and moods. Let me recollect the definition of mood also. As I describe what is feeling, I'll try to explain what mood. Mood is nothing but it is a short term emotional feel which do not have a great impact of happy, sad, anger, disgust, all these things. It is a little duration is little more. That's all.
Mood, sir. Hello.
Please. Yes.
Sir, you can share your screen. Please.
Okay. It is getting reconnected in my system. That's why I find
it's coming, sir.
Oh, now it is visible. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you so much for this.
Thank you, sir.
Please. Okay. So what we are going to cover in this, as I gave you a definition for or meaning for emotion and intelligence, what we are going to deal with for the next 30 to 40 minutes that we have, very few minutes, I would like to take everybody to go with what is the meaning of intelligence as emotional intelligence, how we have to understand our own emotional intelligence, okay, how it is related to IQ. Hope you all know what is the meaning of IQ. Yes, exactly. Let me repeat once again, intelligent quotients. Emotional quotients, intelligent quotients. What is that related? How it is related? Yes, absolutely, they are related. IQ is completely related to your emotions. If you have a strong emotional bond, your IQ level will be more higher. When you have a balanced emotions, you will be a high IQ people. When you are oscillated, your IQ level also will oscillate accordingly. So we'll talk more about this when it comes under that particular section. So let me brief out other points. I want to improve. If you want to improve our emotional intelligence, how we have to proceed? We will discuss on that. And then what are the five different elements that involves in emotional intelligence? And the next one is competency of emotional intelligence. What do you mean by inter and intrapersonal intelligence? Yes. These are all the part that we are going to brief out in this next 40 minutes. So last 10 minutes, we'll have kind of a small questioning based session. We will discuss on that in further if you would like to ask some questions. Yes, we will proceed with the first topic. Yes. How we get all kinds of feelings? First question. Everybody's note their head. If you are stressed out, you will keep your head. You will keep your hand on your head. If you feel tired, you will keep your hand on your head. If you feel excited, you will keep your hands over your head. So, ultimately, the emotional control part is brain. Absolutely, it is brain. So, where exactly that part is? We call it a subconscious mind. So, subconscious mind, we call it as like pons and middle oblongata, cerebellum region, are the place where our emotional, all kinds of emotions comes out through hormonal transactions. So, this is called a deep within the most element part of the brain. This is the deepest thing where all kinds of emotions are being carried to that particular part of the brain, and it will express through our action from our hand, eyes, face, everything. So these are all the regions where intellectual part, our intelligence part takes care. Our reading comprehension area, occipital lobe, sensory speech, how we are talking. People are good at language, they are, this particular regions are more active. So let me not give you a brief detail about this particular thing. So this is the purpose of showing you this image is your brain is the masterpiece of your all kinds of activity that you do. That's what. So keep your brain healthy. I'll tell you, I'll give you the tips towards how to keep your brain healthy also. Okay. Five things what we need to know. Yes, what is intelligence? Emotional intelligence. Yes, we have discussed emotional intelligence. Feelings carried out along with the reasoning ability. Reasoning ability carry undertaken by calculative mind, interrelating, interpreting. These all things will come together and it will help us to decide what and how to act to a particular situation. That is what intelligence is, something what relate. Let me take you to an example. Consider we are walking on a road. Very casually, we are talking, we are very happy. We are talking to our friend and all of a sudden we heard a bombarding sound with a great clash between a bus and a car. How would you react immediately? First emotions will be there. That first emotions, you will get fear and you will be anxious. And what happened exactly? So this is called emotion. Now, immediately intelligent part will start acting to you if you are very normal and if you handle your emotions in a normal way. If you are highly emotional, you will faint down. If you are normal, if you handle that particular emotions under your own control, your intellectual intelligence part will start acting. Simply, it starts reacting to the situation. Instead of reacting with our expression, it will start acting. We have to start acting. So immediately what you will do, rush to that particular location, try to help out the human being. This is what happened. This action, who instruct you to go and save the people, check out what happened inside and how you can save their life. These kind of instructions that comes in your mind and you, when you start doing these things, these are all autonomous nervous system. It will happen involuntarily. Okay. So when your involuntary actions are active, then you have a balanced emotions. So some people like our mom, people from a soft hearted people, most probably from village, most probably from unexposed people, girls or women used to be afraid of looking at horrible things. That's the reason man used to go and take and carry. But nowadays women are getting more exposed to such a kind of thing and they are becoming more bold. So to keep our emotions controlled, intelligence will act. Intelligence will help us to recognize and act in that particular situation. This is what difference with a small example. What we do immediately, we'll go and pull that particular accident, injured persons out. We will start giving first aid to them. We will take their phone and try to contact with the people. Immediately, some of the people will call 108 and they'll try to bring ambulance to this particular location. One people will come and pour water. How? This is how we become more intelligence. So our intelligence plays the role with emotions. If you don't have any kind of feeling, you won't act at all. So we need to regulate our own thing. So this is a small example where we involuntarily do so many things. Why we need to protest? Why we need to preserve our Jallikattu? Why we are protesting against? We have our own traditions. That's the reason we emotionally, intellectually, we want to save our breed of bull and cow. To protect them, we started protest. We want that pet issues. I think I'm with you all. Hope you all are following me. If you raise your hand, I'll be happy. I'll consider that you all are with me. Okay, thank you so much. We'll go with the next thing. Yes, emotional intelligence, how it is going to affect our career. Career, of course, everybody are working. Everybody are doing something to survive in their life. Yes. How it is related? I'll take one small example. Hope you have seen a movie called Saatai in Tamil. Saatai is a movie. The people, those who haven't seen, I'll just brief you out about the small theme of that particular movie. That movie is the hero used to react. He will not react to the opponent. he will act what he wants to, his intentions, what he what says inside him, he will act. He will never react to the opposite person. That is the role of that particular character in that particular movie. Simply, his intention, the movie, I think maximum teachers would have seen this particular movie, Satay, the Samudrakani movie. So what he do actually, that whole movie is based on emotional intelligence. Absolutely. The intention of that particular teacher is to bring the next generation students to the next level. Though it is government school, they wants to bring their life up irrespective of the negative things. So this is what emotional intelligence in the career. I'll correlate with another example. Let us take it as corporate company, corporate work life. Here it comes work life and personal life. Very, very difficult and very, very toughest part to handle your personal life and your professional life. Some people take personal things to the office, some people take professional things to the home, and he mess with everything. He or she will mess with everything. Simply. So here, emotional intelligence will play a great role. How? Keeping a distance. First point, I'll tell you how to improve my how is my emotional intelligence is fixed. There, this answer will be this question will be answered. When you are considering your professional life is the most important thing, you will give less value to your personal life. Never ever do that. You have to balance. Both are equal. Money is required to live. If money is more, your livelihood will go down. When you don't have family, when your family is not carrying you, or you are not carrying your family, when you're not loving your daughter or a son or a wife, what is the purpose? What is the mean of earning money in lot of earning money? So that is how we should balance both things. Even though money is important, family is important. We should give equal importance. Now we'll get into actual professional life. Professional life is, I have started my career after completing 12th standard. I took a break. In that particular 1 year, I worked as a customer care executive in a MNC company. That was my first job. I'll take only 1 minute to describe this. The whole culture of MNC is new to me. I was behaving like a child. I do not know anything about corporate world. But still, they have treated me equal to them. Why they need to treat me equal to them? Because they want the job or the work to be done perfectly. If they discourage or depreciate, if they create a feel of difference, I won't be able to work productively. Similarly, whomever is working with us, we need to respect them first. We should give them proper response, respect. Response and addressing the query. We should respect them, respond them properly, and addressing if they are coming up with any query or help them in the need. Do not take anything personal from them or give them personal. This is the learning part of my first career in the corporate world. Yes, that helped me a lot to proceed in my corporate and career life. So this is my small explanations towards dealing with your career part. Okay, now let us come back to the part called EQ and IQ. So EQ, I told you emotional intelligence is related to, let me recall all the points. Yes, happiness, sadness, guilt feel, pain feel, disturbed, disgust. I'm giving you expression because disgust means you don't like things. Pain means, and there are two things. If we take one particular pain related to surroundings, one particular pain within ourselves, feeling about ourselves interior is one type of pain. Getting affected, getting scoldings or being affected by the next person is another type of pain. So these two types of pain is used to disturb and create a great emotional distraction happens, and that will lead to your stress level. It will go, it will create a great stress level, and the next level will become frustrations, and it will create a lot of mood upset, and your whole life will be destroyed. But when you are thinking about positive attitude, I'll connect this point with positive attitude. If you have that kind of mindset, your IQ level, your thinking ability will be zero, completely zero. Meanwhile, I'll just connect it with my laptop again. It got disconnected. Okay, let me come back again. Yes, password. Waiting password is going wrong. 809-726. Okay, I'm back again. On this computer again, sharing the screen. Sir, host has disabled my screen sharing. So kindly allow me to proceed. Sir, Arun KS, I'm not able to share my screen. Please look into that, sir.
Arun sir, you can share.
I'm not able to.
Yeah, you can.
Yes. Now. Thank you so much, sir. So let us come back to the point. IQ, intelligent quotients. What is that? If I ask you, what is 4 into 5? Now it is very simple because it has been taught from the school. It is 4 2s are 20. If I ask you 5,000 into 4,000, if we are smart enough, we will multiply only 5 into 4, and the zero will be added again. And then, when you are a little disturbed, when you are completely out of your mind, if someone, your daughter or a son, if they come and ask you, Dad, what is the sum of 50 and 20? If you are disturbed, you won't be able to calculate. That is fact. I'll tell you, it happens with everyone. When you are not maintaining your, this is breaking. Okay, Sahithi, try to come to the place where you can get the proper signal. Okay, so that's all about the IQ level. Maintain the EQ level to maintain to getting break. Amina Zubin. Okay, is it fine now? Hello? Okay, let me continue with the concepts. Those who are listening, let me proceed with them. The point is, when you are disturbed, you cannot use your IQ. To improve your IQ level, what we should do? We should concentrate one thing at a time. I'll tell you one thing. If I am talking to you, if I am doing something, okay, sir. If I'm talking to you, if I do something related to our talk, to our discussion, is called one action. Our brain is designed in such a manner that it can do magic. It will do magic. But it can accept only one command at a time. Many of them do not know the secret of this. They consider that I am a multi-talented. Yes, of course, people are multi-talented. Yes, of course, people are multitasking. They do not understand the meaning of multitasking and multi-talented. So IQ, when they have higher IQ level, they will be multitasking people. At a time, they will write, see, meanwhile, I'm talking to my phone, I'm looking into my screen, I'm using my pen to take a note, I'm answering to this phone. It doesn't mean that I am multi-talented. No, my focus is, 90% of focus is to talk. Okay, 10% of focus is related to the talk. If you are doing that, 100% your IQ level will improve day by day. That is how we have to improvise our IQ level. Emotional level, yes, for that you need to identify who you are. We will proceed with that. Okay, I have another point, another slide to tell you, to show you. This is another part of brain. Perception, another important part, perception, what you see. how you see. It is a part of a positive attitude concepts. So auditory informations, what we listen, it get into your mind and it will create a new meaning to it, motor neurons. So this is a small example. So I want to show you. Okay, now we'll take you to the short. It is actually a very big concept, can't be discussed in next 10 minutes or 30 minutes. Still, I would like to take you to the next part. Empathy, motivation, social skills, self-awareness, self-regulation. If you really want to improvise your emotional intelligence, you should know how to deal with these part. I repeat once again, empathy, motivation, social skills, self-awareness, self-regulation. I think if you are noting it down, I'll tell you what is the meaning of empathy. You would have seen the word, you would have heard the word called empathy and sympathy. Yes, everybody know the meaning of empathy. Yes, how, what is the meaning? What is the real meaning of it? How it involves with emotions? Yes, empathizing someone is also an important role for any matured attitude people. If you are really matured, you have to address someone's greediness, someone's problem or a pain. If you really want to be highly matured, only when you address somebody's pain or empathetically, then definitely you will be a highly emotional person and highly emotional intelligence. Yes, looking from other point of view, absolutely right. So when someone coming, exactly, well, let me take a point. I have a small story I'll tell you at the end. Everything will be related to it. Okay, so now empathy, what I feel. If I feel for you, that is sympathy. Completely, I'm taking your role, is called sympathy. If I am suffering from fever, the opposite person also feels the same, is empathy. If he is considering that I'm also suffering from fever, is sympathy. So never ever put yourself completely to that particular issue, but understand the situation from that particular point of view. Absolutely, point of view is called empathy. Do not empathize people. Okay, create a compassion to them. That will be the real heal to any human being if they are into some bad situation. Okay, now improving your thing, we guessed. So now tell me, what are the strategies that we need to follow to improvise our emotional intelligence? Gap is because to think. Simply, if I want to develop my skill, if I want to lead a successful, what I should do? What I do? Immediately, what I'll do? I will try to add good qualities to my daily activities. That is how we have to. That should connect with emotions. You should have a strong feeling that tomorrow morning, 5 o'clock, I will go and play. To my heart. Okay. Then the second thing, thoughts. When your emotion is connected with your thoughts, that thought process need to be aligned properly. Hope you understand aligning. When your thought process, it will have. See, when we are sitting silently, thousands of thoughts will come and bombard our head. We need to be smart enough to pick them properly. When we are picking the thoughts properly, automatically we will become that. Swami Vivekananda said a true thing which completely what I follow. Vivekananda said that, who are you? If someone asks to Vivekananda, he says simply, when you're sitting alone at home or you're silently seated in a place, whatever the thought comes in your mind or whatever the thoughts that you accept, those thoughts are you. This is what the explanation he gave. So I'll repeat once again. The thought comes into your mind when you're alone, when you're silent, when you're without your electronic device or a system, without any work. If you sit silently, certain things comes into your mind. Those thoughts are you. It is human being. Human behavior is a product of our thoughts. Absolutely. Those thoughts, if it is positive thoughts, if you are smart enough to identify what is positive thoughts, you will be a positive person. Your action will be positive. If your action If your action is positive, your outgone performance will become absolutely positive. This is how you change your, improve your emotional intelligence. Yes. Now I'll repeat once again the same thing. Thought process is the most important thing. Choose your thoughts wisely. If it is disturbing you, ignore that particular thoughts. Okay, let me go into that. See, our performance, I'll show you. Our performance is based on the emotions that we deal with. I'll tell you, at the age, when I was studying 7th standard, I was brought up in my granny's house, grandmother's house. I'll just connect it within a 5 minutes. My grandmother, so I was under no control, to be frank. Whatever I feel, whatever I want, I will do it. But my mom and my dad told me few things. They were not with me. They were settled in Gujarat, Surat. So I am in Tamil Nadu, they are in Surat. So our communication is only through phone. And our meeting is only in a year, once in a year. Freedom at the age, younger age, can lead to anything. That particular thing. And freedom plus my mom dad's instruction. These two things helped me to mold myself. The instructions, we are nothing but a product of our surrounding. Who I am is a product of my own thoughts. Remember this point. Who I am is a product of surrounding. Within me, who I am is product of my own thoughts. My action is my thought, and the learning part, what I learned from my environment or my surrounding, is my behavior. So what I'm trying to connect here is when I go and see the people who are suffering, they are not getting food, they are underprivileged, discrimination action was taken in a great place, a particular village is not given a proper solution, they are completely suffering like anything, even for one day food. At that time, I realized, if being a human, what I can do? At that time, I have no choice or to give money or to give them food, because I am already into someone's hand where they are feeding me. So at that time, I decided emotionally. One particular paper, newspaper, was printed with a small 2 or 3 years old kid. Working in a quarry, beating a stone, and another baby behind that particular child is crying for food. And this two baby child, one baby child is breaking, and the other baby child is crying. This image created, and it affected me like anything. Then I decided to eliminate child laborism. I don't want any child to suffer like that at that particular age. Though everybody is emotional, right? And that particular age, that kind of emotional development happened. Then I decided, what if I become so that I can overcome that particular emotion, overcome that kind of problem. I don't want any small kids to suffer like that. What I should do? Then I fixed slowly. I want to become a powerful person to help them out. What are the powerful person? 8th standard, what I can think, that's all. I thought like I want to become a district collector, like something like that. Sounded like good, and I fixed that as my aim at that age. Started collecting all the information. So my emotional part helped me to fix my goal, and I started following towards my goal. So emotional was absolutely handled with intelligence. I do not know this is right or wrong, but I want to help. That's it. So certain positive thinking will help you to lead you or improvise your emotional intelligence. This is my own life experience. So now, if you really want to upgrade yourself or change your life, change your daily activities, automatically you will start enjoying your life. This will say, everyone will say, but the one who follows will be the best person. If you want to change, you have to do it, not me. If I say, it is you just heard. Hearing and listening are the two different information. So hearing is emotional. Intelligence means listening. If you listen it, it will get into your head. If it is getting into your head, automatically you will start implementing what is right. That is how you can improvise your emotional intelligence. Let me get into the social part quickly. So socially, how we are all connected. As you told, a human being is connected with surrounding and external surrounding and internal surrounding. So let us quickly go through with what kind of skills that we should develop from our society. Love life, work life, I discussed already. Friendship, yes, friendship. Every section we can take a half an hour session. So let me quickly say, friendship means be true to yourself, be true to your friend, irrespective of the opposite person's trueness or transparency. If they betray you or if they do any wrong things to you, do not do from your end. Do not take a revenge. Karma will do that. Keep this saying inside. If your friend is doing or if your friend is cheating to you, never mind. If he's cheating, stop the negative person. Consider him as a negative person. Stop sharing your most personal or emotional thing to them. Because if a person is betraying you or cheating you, is no longer your friend. Never ever try to repeat what he did. We never bark at a dog when a dog is barking at us. So consider. Sorry if I use any abuse words. It is just a small example point of view. I have taken the word called dog. So I'm not relating any human being with animals. Absolutely, we are learning from other animals also. What is the meaning of sympathy? What is the meaning of trueness? What is the meaning of loyalty? So friendship means what, as a person, how you are friends to you, to others, to the society. Think in that perspective and be good friend to your friends. Never expect that the opposite person has to be good. Let us complete. Next part, I'll go with the sports and team. When you are physically enthusiastically participating in your day-to-day activity, automatically your energy level will be boosted higher. There is a saying called healthy body, healthy mind. Hope most of you have heard about this. Please use these kind of phrases and quotes frequently to yourself so that you will keep your self-motivation to a certain level. If you will never feel yourself low. Okay, so do physical activity. That will help you to understand certain things. Sports and team, actually, I have to go through with rules and regulations. See, sports means we have to follow certain rules to play that particular game. Team means we have to work as a team. We have to play as a team to win one particular task. Here, team building, teamwork plays a great role. Sports has a rules. Is conditioned and team helping us to behave with the group. Group behavior and conditioned rules, rule-based activity, physical activity is performed, which is very, very mandatory for every human being. That's the reason schools and colleges are conducting and the Olympics is conducting. That's the reason. Okay, schools, what we have to learn from schools, actual meaning of behavior. What do we have to learn from our school? What is the actual meaning of behavior? Second, what is the subject? Most of the schools are concentrating more on subject, less on behavior. That is the reason that people have started moving towards the inanimated object called, inhuman object called mobile phone. Most of the students are not respecting the human nowadays because they do not know how to react to a particular situation. What we have to learn from a school? Subject and behavior. That behavior will, I'll try to put one more quote here. One of the famous quote, tolerance is the highest point of education. I repeat, tolerance is the highest point of education. We are getting educated from school and colleges. The tolerance power do we have? If something is happening in and around you, do you have the patience to deal with that particular thing? If you have, you are educated. If you're not, you are not educated. Even though you completed PhD or even though you got a lot of n number of awards, when you do not have the tolerance, what happens in and around your society, then definitely you need to get educated more. That is what we have to learn from the school personally. So school, what we need to learn, we have to learn behavior and subjects. Love life, absolutely. Every human being should care for each other. That's all. Love doesn't mean that never ever look a word in a different perspective. While we will have positive attitude in the next part. So let me quickly rush through. Love life, we will deal with that. Group and clubs, again, teamwork. Already I've told you about team activity here. The same thing will happen here. when we are with a group or a club, we need to encourage everybody, we need to help them, we need to discuss them, we need to do all sorts of things as a group, not as an individual. Home, yes, mom is the first and the foremost person what when we come onto this earth, we see them, we see her. Whatever a mom says, a child will listen. If so many moms are here in this live video, please learn the art of growing child. The art of growing is parenting is a great thing where only that particular mom can make a good, bring up a good child. So second, dad. Dad is the most responsible person. Any children, the role model is mom and dad. They do not know whether it is true or not. For the first and always, mom and dad are always role model for any children. So you be the best model and best person to them. And automatically your child will be to the upper level. His emotions will be highly managed. One more thing I want to add here in at home. I have counseled almost more than 200 parents to child rearing or how to give parentinghood. I'll add a few words which is being followed by most of the people. If you want your child or if you want your next generation to the upper and the top level, don't condition and control them. Don't try to control their emotion. Please take care of their action. Don't stop their action, but take care of their action. It has a lot of meaning. So take it in the right option. If a child is going to climb a tree, please hold them. Do not pull them down. If a child wants to climb a tree, go and hold. Just hold them. Let him try. How far he can climb up? That child do not. But what as a parent, as a father, as a mother, what do you need to do? Hold them. Let him climb. To a certain stage, he will understand or she will understand, I can't do more than this. Then automatically it will come. This is a small example. Don't condition and control them. Support them and be careful about their action. That's all. If you are missing out this understanding and watching their action, again a problem. So make sure you give a good parents and you can maintain their emotions, because controlling and seizing their activity will create a great imbalance in emotional part. I have a student I'm training him. He is talking to his mother in the morning and I was surprised. He was talking to me very politely, very humbly, very respectfully. He received a phone like this. Okay. Please send that mail. I don't want that. Please do this. This is the tone that he showed. I was wondered, why are you talking to your mother like this? And I don't like my mother and dad. He said, he's studying in 12th standard. He's telling that I don't like mother and dad. Literally, all mothers and dads will always do good for the children by physically giving the physical gadgets. Whereas when it comes to emotional part, they don't do. Because they are not aware of it. So whenever you come across someone is controlling a small kid, because our creativity, as a child, people born with higher level of creativity and logical thinking. As they grow higher in this surrounding society, their IQ level, they are growing, their thinking ability goes down. When they are kid, they will make miracle things. When they grow, they will stop. Because of the conditioning, because of the control, they lose their mind. They will be unquestioned. I don't know what I am doing. Please do not create such a situation so that they do not know what emotions they have. Respect their emotions. Okay? So this is what I am happy. I want to share it as a parenting thing. But when it comes to relationship, it will be the another part. So we'll go to the quick second one. Emotional competence. Now it is the time for talking to self. Self-regulation. So what do you mean by self-awareness? So what is that self-awareness? Hope you know, who are you? Simple question, who are you? If you ask who are you, if answer is blank, you need to research. Yes, of course. Many of them be blank. Who I am? Daily ask these questions to yourself. Put a note. Write a diary. I have a small diary like this, or at least like this. Small notepad to note down who are you. So this self-awareness will give a definite shape to you. This is called a self-concept. When you understand your own self, when you know this is what I am, Arun means can walk to only 3 kilometers means Arun can walk only for 3 kilometers. Next day, I can improve for 100 meters extra. I cannot plan for 10 kilometers. So when you really realize your own self, automatically you can slowly improvise yourself to reach the height. Immediately you cannot go to the last step. You have to go one by everybody. So this is what I am trying to tell. Understand yourself first. Go slowly. Automatically your value will go higher after understanding your own self. Second part is called regulation. Every day you have to monitor your own self. How? Have a habit of noting down, writing a diary. Little complicated, yes. Inculcating a new hobby or a habit in our daily life is little complicated because we are used to enjoy the laziness. Hope you know it. Yes? Yeah. We used to. Amma, 5 o'clock. Oh, 5 o'clock, I can't wake up. But night, with full energy, I will wake up at 5 o'clock. You will write intense, you will tell to everybody. But what you will do? What you will do automatically, mommy? After 8 o'clock, you will wake up, you will be depressed. You know how? You have planned in the night one, and early morning, you did something else. So here, great misunderstanding. This is called mind-body coordination. So mind-body coordination needs to be proper so that you will have a great understanding among yourself. This understanding matters a lot. If, for example, I'll tell you, this regulation, when you understand who you are, and then when you start improvising yourself slow by slow, automatically your confidence level will go higher and higher. That higher and higher confidence level goes, automatically you will be self-motivated. Nothing. It is not something wonder or someone on, only great people can do. When you do, you also become a great people. Simple logic. It is not someone who fall from other planet or fall from stars or someone. No one become great until unless they start doing the great thing every day. Every day when they start, when they're doing great thing, automatically they'll become a great person. You need not to follow some legends. You follow certain your own principles, you'll become legend. This is how legendary people used to follow. Simple thing, difference between the other person and you, that small extra effort, that small extra mile that you walk, that small extra, konjam adhigam, inna konjam mela. So this is what, thoda zyada kar lete hain. Kya hota hai, dekh lete hain. When you have this attitude, when you have the smile, automatically you will be self-motivated. Self-motivated, I told already about empathy. So this is what intrapersonal, you know, hope you know the meaning of intrapersonal and interpersonal. Intrapersonal means something you talk to yourself, something you do to yourself, love yourself. When you are loving yourself, you will start enjoying yourself. Go for a self-dating. Yes, this is the motive part of my friend, my guru. He used to go for a self-dating. 15 days once, weekly once, go for self-dating. You hope you all know the meaning of dating. Yes, nothing wrong with it all. Whatever you do, whatever you love, do. You love to swim, you love to talk to a dog, you love to carry yourself to the other location. Yes, go for a walk, go for swimming, go for planting, go for shooting, go for anything what you love. That is how you improvise your own self. And that is how you will feel that I am living. When you have that feel of I am living, automatically you will start doing wonders. So that wonders will create wonderful society. That wonderful society is what required for our next generation. So that is how our emotions and the competence has to be. Okay. So let me teach you a few points that I have already participated. Take time to mindfulness. Think about yourself and do something for your own self. But then recognize what type of emotions you have. You are more sensitive to the opposite person scolding, note down. I don't like scoldings. Another point. Write down another one. Recognize if you are more sensitive to the smell, write down. You are more emotional towards the crying, write down. I'm more emotional person, sir. I'm more sensitive, sir. If I show one dull face, automatically some people will start crying. That type of personalities are there. For them, we need to be very careful dealing with them. Understanding emotion is very important to deal with any human behavior. Every human being are fluctuating with their emotions. If you are suffering from dengue, you have medicine. If you are suffering from cold, we have Mruddhanjan. If we are suffering from knee pain, we have Valium. If we are suffering from eye problem, we have eye drops and specs. If you are suffering from inner self, only human person can talk. Only words are the only medicine. So please spread only the right and the positive words to the others. Though you are not getting, at least you give it. So next, understanding the cause of feeling. This is what I was discussing about now. So others and your own feeling. Why you are feeling so low? Why are you so feeling unattached? Sometimes I feel like I'm not why I'm living. Sometimes you feel like, abba, why enduku nenu ilaga chestna? Me as a pure category. So many words, so many songs are there. Based on that, it is being created. You will be attracted towards those points. So when you feel that you are something different, unusual thing, go for sleep. Find an alternative option. Listen to the music. Go for swimming. Talk to a children. Go and have a small cakewalk on the floor or upstairs. That is how you will realize why you are you feeling so low or different. Okay, difference between emotions and actions. Yes, if I'm highly tensed or anger. Hope everybody are aware of this particular feeling. If you are anger or emotion, automatically what you will do, you will scold everybody. You will do, idu enduku ikkada undi, why is this here? Morning if you wake up with this irritating mindset, whatever you see, you will start scolding at it. At that situation, what we need to do, take a bath, cool your body first, look at flowers, trees, look at the peaceful things which is surrounded us. That's the reason we need to have a peaceful statue. Why we are decorating our home? Just to change, trigger our mood. Knowingly or unknowingly, that is triggering our mood. So keep positive things, keep your house clean, keep your bedroom clean, keep all smiley and good words around your house and around your place. When you are irritated, those things will change your mood. One, when your inner self is not appropriate, you sit calmly, automatically everything will be all right. Have the feeling that everything will be all right in a few minutes. Okay, next point, differentiating your emotions and the needs to take action. Yes, I'm highly angry, but still I want to go to that particular place where I don't understand. Recent situations, the difference between the reaction and the composite. Ma'am, can you come again one second? Come again with the same point. Let me check with the chat. The difference between the reaction and the composed response in given situations must be understand. Exactly, agree to it. Okay, so we will discuss on that. Next point, preventing depression. Yes, I told you this word, learned optimism. We have positive attitude sessions, we will discuss more on that particular thing. Okay, managing anger through learned behavior. Learn anger is a one of the universal disease where everybody get anger. The one who start controlling that particular anger will be the legend. So you decide whether you want to become a legend or anger person. You versus anger. Arun or anger. Who is going to win? Fight. Decide, Arun or anger. If you are allowing anger to win, then why are you living? Ask this question to yourself. Make it, Arun has to win. Anger cannot control me. I can control anger. Your emotions, your part, everything is under your own control. So make sure everything is under.
Arun sir, hello. Excuse me sir, you have muted your mic. Hello sir, please unmute your mic.
Sir, your own. Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, what was the last word I told? I was talking about session is nice, learn something. Okay, I and Anushiva. Thank you, sir. Okay. So now the point is dealing with. Okay. Anger management. Anger management is another very, very important self-management. Always remember. Always remember. Anger is the weakest part of any human being. If you consider yourself the strongest person, never ever allow that anger to rule you. You can rule the anger. Anger is a normal thing. It is like air. It will come anywhere. It will come from anywhere. There are two ways of anger. It is from external and internal. You personally get irritated, because of that you will get anger, or some person will come and irritate you, and because of that you will get anger. Why? You have to screen yourself. You have to screen yourself so that you can differentiate why I am getting anger. What are naming emotions, sir? Naming emotions. Which section is talking about? Guts feeling. Kindly provide the feedback link. Okay. Developing listening skills. Absolutely very wonderful part. The last one. Listening skills. Not everybody are good at. Okay. Unjustified your ideas about it. Yes. Idea about me is like, sir, I will address to you this questions in the last 5 minutes. So I have few slides to talk to you about that. So we'll talk to you about that. Sure. So, developing to the listening skills. Listening skills is something which you allow your ear to observe the thing. Listening and observing is the most important skill that everybody has to listen. Everybody has to develop and cultivate it. Some people have by default, we call it as like natural skill and acquired skill. Some people by default, they have tendency to observe everything. Some people by doing certain activity, they develop their listening skill. Listening, observing, understanding, reading, and writing. These are all the LSRW concepts which will help everybody to move to the next level, like next level in the sense like making their own life, deriving their own life. We'll go with managing yourself, managing your team, managing at work, managing collaborative, self-awareness. All the points, if you follow, you will automatically start managing yourself by understanding your own thing. Next, managing your team is like empathy, developing the others. So these are all the points. So questions will be addressed in the last 5 minutes. Sure. We have another PPT called positive attitude. Positive attitude. Okay. Before I start with this, I have a small story. Kindly lend your ears. Try to understand what is that story is all about. This is not a story actually. I used to go and take classes for banking students. One of my students, he is like polio attacked. Sorry to say that he cannot walk by himself. He used to carry a walking stick, and his limbs are not well developed. His hands are not well developed. He used to talk to me friendly because I used to motivate the people like that. So one day he called me, not one day, last week he called me. He told me a few incidents. He got the permission, actually, the respect he gave, kindness that he proceeded. It attracted me like anything. When you are so lovely, or when you are so kind enough, nobody will say no to you. So be kind to the people. Only when you are kind, nobody will feel down. So he called me and said, I want to talk to you personally, sir. Can I take few minutes? I can't say no for this, because he sounded in such a way, he sounded so politely, that I created my own time for him and I listened. He started telling some personal things, and both emotional intelligence as well as positive attitude involved in this story. So please try to
differentiate that. So what he said, sir, I got a proposal from a girl, sir. And I was smiling at him. Oh, that's really wonderful. His name is Kamaraj. So it's really wonderful, Kamaraj. Wow. And he said, hesitantly, he said that, sir, but I don't know what to give result, what to give, how to give response. Why? She likes you, so why don't you say yes to her? Immediately he told, sir, I got that particular proposal through Facebook, sir. Facebook. He got that particular proposal through Facebook. He never met him in person. So he said that, sir, my limbs are not developed. So if I go and meet, looking at my physical appearance, you say, if she rejected, I'll be disappointed, sir. I will get disheartened, sir. So I do not know what to choose and how to react to the situation. And I told him, okay, so what is your inner voice saying? Sir, I'm confused, sir. Confused. Then don't give any reaction. Don't give any kind of response. Be cool. I told immediately then. Immediately I told him that, do you think that you can lead your married life? He said, I wanted to lead my married life. His age is like between 23 to 26. And he called me to inform that he got appointed. He got positive result in RBI. He got assistant bank. Being that particular physically challenging physique he has, still he prepared well and he achieved it. And now he is an employee of RBI. And that positivity. And he told, yes, sir, I also want to lead a married life. How do you think that is possible? Sir, I was depressed. I was disappointed after this proposal, after thinking. I shared this information with my friends. Immediately, they were laughing at me and they told me, sir, how can you lead your happy life? And he got disappointed. And sir, everybody is disappointing me. Everybody is disappointing me. So please tell me, sir, if they are disappointing me, what I should do. Then I told, disappointing me. There are two mantra that you should follow. One is ignorance. Second thing is acceptance. This is what you are going to do, see as here. So ignorance and acceptance. I told him, and he was quite surprised. Sir, what is the meaning of ignorance acceptance? Accept the proposal. Ignore the negative words. If they are keep on demotivating you, keep those words away from you. Create a shield around you and start protecting yourself from the dangerous words. That is called ignorance. And accept your own self for being a positive person. Not everybody can crack RBI examination. You have cracked. Keep all the positive words. Tell yourself that, yes, I did this. Not frequently. Don't allow anybody to be your friend. Don't allow anybody to be your best friend. Don't allow anyone to occupy you. You occupy yourself. This is what I said. The result, after that, he told another word. Sir, I came out after writing the examination hall. I was standing for a bus. There, I saw a couple with a child begging. I was surprised to see them. Even they were suffering like me, and that man do not have a well-developed limb, legs. Still, he is holding a small baby child, and he is with his wife. That is the positivity that he understood. Surrounding is the best. Our environment is the best teacher to take. What is your vision? If you are positive inside, automatically you will see all positivity around you. This is what he gave. That explanation was amazing. Sir, when that particular beggar, he is begging, he has the same problem what I have. Still, he is with his wife and with his daughter. Why can't I hear, sir? Keep up your spirit, comrades. This is how you have to deal with any negative situation. Your surrounding is depreciating your inner energy. If they are exploiting your own positive energy, never mind. there are so many positive things running around us. Look for that, enjoy that, I told him. And that is how he was convinced. So now, positive attitude. Let us come back to the last session of positive attitude. Positive attitude means thinking about ourselves own and how we are and how people are. A small question. What do you see here? Can you see a screen? What is the screen? What are the, this is a perception point. According to your mindset, see what is this. There are two hidden images. These two hidden images, one particular hidden image is showing a sad expression, one is showing a happy expression. It depends upon, if you are sad, you will see the sad face. If you are happy, you will see the happy face. Always keep yourself happy and stay, unlearn all negative words. You know, can't do, impossible, you are fit for nothing. All these kinds of perception, all these kinds of negative words, stay away from them. Unlearn all the negative words. Never care about opposite person is using those particular negative words. You be the positive using word. You be the person who use positive words. And you talk to them politely. You talk to them. Being you will help, will teach the Arun. Arun means like this only. Manju means will be like this only. X, Y, Z. So you are going to decide who you are. So make sure you unlearn all the negative words. Fill your mind, keep everything positive words in you. So positive thinking around us are so many things, like listening, what you listen, what you see, what you speak. So this is what I said, use positive words to reply, use positive vision, whatever you see. Simple example, if you are having a phone, if your background screen is a smiley baby face, whenever you see that particular smiley baby face, automatically you will feel happy. When you have a pleasant music as a ringtone, automatically when the sound comes, your inner emotions trigger to happiness. So this is how you have to arrange yourself, organize yourself, your surrounding, your positive building format. Okay, next step. Build your positive words. Yes, we discussed converting the negative words to the positive words. If someone comes and sit, talk to you in all rubbish, all nonsense thing, how will you listen to this? Don't listen at all. Observe what is the intensity or observe what is the intention of that particular talk. Excuse me. Intention of any talk will be there. Identify the intention. That intention will help you. If you are able to identify the reason behind of doing or identifying the intention behind of doing will help you to decide whether you should proceed with that particular person or not. So if someone is keep on pondering, keep on disturbing, distracting you, ignore them. Or if someone, if your loved one is ignoring you like anything, be patient. This is what another two mantras. So another true great mantra is be patient, ignore. What does it mean? So Shaina ma'am, mean means patience. If someone come and link is completely asking to fill like numbers. Okay. So learn to ignore things. So that is the key to keep yourself happy and make sure you keep ignoring the wrong things, not everything. So learn to say no. You need not to admit, you need not to accept everything. Another mantra. See, again, these are all the few words will trigger you to keep yourself safe apart from exploitation. So someone comes and keep on disturbing, distracting. Sometimes you say no to them so that you will keep yourself calm and be ready to accept the right thing. So positive attitude leads to positive results. This is the final slide that I want to show you. So thank you so much. And I'll try to address a few questions if you have anything. Last 5 minutes, we will discuss about only numbers asking. So if you, ma'am, of the people who are online, if you have any questions, please raise your questions so that we will wind up the session in few minutes. Okay. I'm waiting for your questions. If you can, if you have any doubts or to be something to be clarified, I'll clarify. Isn't working from the previous meetings. Okay, yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. It's impossible to say no to all because some circumstances may use. Yes, absolutely. We consider that as a certainty and uncertainty. There are certainty, certain things that we can accept it. There are certain things under our own control where we can say no. We cannot, if you have 1,000 rupees more of your own, someone is coming and asking for 10 rupees, where it is very, very important for them to give buy food. You have 1,000 rupees and he is asking for 10 rupees for food. Absolutely, you can give the 10 rupees because being a human, we have to serve for people. That 10 rupees makes a great difference to here. You need not to send you.
Hello, Mansoor sir.
Sir, unmute.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Please proceed.
Myself, Mansoor Ahmed Wani, research scholar from Jammu and Kashmir UT. My two questions.
Jammu and Kashmir. Okay.
Yes, good. Sir. My two questions are to esteemed Dr. Arun Kumar, sir. First, I extend my felicitations and good wishes to all the participants, and I am thankful to the organizers of this webinar. Hope for few more such webinars. Really, it was an insightful session from worthy Dr. Arun Kumar, sir. My question is,
thank you so much for this.
If a person in an accident or incident helps involuntary for safer side, I mean controlling side, is that person using his IQ intelligence properly in life?
Okay.
My second question.
I'm sorry. Can you tell me your name? No. I'm not dealing with your first question. Your good name?
Mansoor Ahmed Wani.
Manju. Okay. Mansoor Ahmed. I'm Ram.
Sorry, I got a call. Mansoor Ahmed Wani, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, give me a second, let me connect my Bluetooth.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you're audible. Yes, you're audible. Come on, yes. Proceed, Amanjana.
Sir, my first question is, if a person in an accident or incident helps involuntary for safer side, is that person using his IQ intelligence properly in life?
Okay. What's the second question?
Sir, you mentioned a word, self-awareness. Will I make synonym for it? That is self-realization. Will make a man valuable or high in nature?
Yes.
These are the two questions from my side, sir.
Okay, we'll answer your question now. Okay, I hope that, let me recall, if a person met with an accident, with our IQ level, what we have to do and how we have to address, right? Second question is self-realization and self-awareness. What is that?
Do I consider them both synonyms or not?
Both synonyms, yes. Self-awareness and self-prayer. Let me go with the second question. Self-awareness means knowing about your own self. It is again, the self-realization is also similar to that. Not exactly, it is similar to that.
Yes,
self-realization means, see, I am very kind and I am very helpful is my self-realization. Okay, self-awareness means if someone is going to come and hit me, first time unknowingly it hit it on my face. Second time if I cross the particular location or a place, my conscious mind will tell that be careful, this place is a dangerous place. This is called self-awareness.
Yes, sir.
Hope you are clear with the point. Self-realization means knowing your own value. Self-awareness means you have to predict your own self in a same and similar way. So it is equivalent, not equal. There are so many situations which will be considered to be standard. In some certain point, it will be different. I think you are happy with that question.
Yes, sir. Satisfied.
Okay, with your second question, first question, yes. When a person, unknown person, you're talking about your own accident or someone accident?
Natural incident. Help us for safer side.
Okay, naturally. You can go with the so many scenarios. Scenic way example, like accident may be natural or artificial. Natural calamities accident is also there, where car bike accident is also there. Knowingly or unknowingly, if you are undergoing or if you are coming across with an accident, intellectually, IQ level, how you have to use your IQ. Simple. Go and try to give first aid. That is called IQ. First, in that, what you need to be conscious. If you do not know, at least call someone who know about it. You do not know what to do. At least raise a voice. Someone come and help him or someone come and help him. What are the possible things?
Yes, sir.
What are the possible things you can do by yourself is you have to do. See, for example, I'm not a doctor. I'm not a medical doctor. I cannot go and give an injection. But what I can do, I can make a call to 108 to call ambulance. Am I right? I can do one thing.
Suggestion.
First safer place. Accident zone. From the accident zone, I can bring them to a safer place. What I can do, I can pour some water to make you conscious. So these are all the IQ that acts according to the along with your emotion. So only when you have the feeling, you will do this. If you do not have such a feeling, you won't do it. I think I have addressed your question. I think few more questions are there.
Thank you, sir.
We will see you in. Thank you so much. And all the best for your future.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, Dr. Arun Kumar. Thank you.
Welcome. Next, any other questions? Can address? We'll have another 10 minutes to proceed. Is there anybody else to get, so that we can wind up the session? Someone was expecting me to answer. Yes, please. Okay, meanwhile the feedback session is going on, we can discuss with that.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the presentation. Now I invite Ms. Tagira ma'am to give a vote of thanks.
Vote of thanks.
Okay. Sir, am I audible, sir?
Yes, audible, ma'am.
Sir, am I audible? Audible,
yes, loud and clear.
Yes, you are.
Good evening to one and all. On behalf of Annai College of Arts and Science, I deem it a great pleasure to propose the vote of thanks. First of all, I would like to thank the resource person of today's session, Dr. Arun Kumar Selvam, who has enlightened and motivated us with this powerful speech on positive attitude and emotional intelligence. Thank you, sir. I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to our college management, principal, vice principals, IQSE ma'am, organizers, head of the department, and all my colleagues. Last but not least, I would like to thank all the participants individually for taking effort to participate and made the session a grand one. Once again, I thank you all. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you for the wonderful session, management team and the principal, for the wonderful opportunity. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I'm really happy for such a wonderful session. I think everything went well without any glitches.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.